You don't have any options. You can't add implants, you can't do nothing. But you'll have another problem. You'll have all the metal in the buccal area. There is a chance that you can't mill the bridge itself. We use special type of sleeve that is only 1.5 millimeters in height. It's a great solution in cases when you have large span and you need to compensate. It's not a regular case when you can use all of the parts and you can do crazy aesthetics and you can do everything.
Hi, welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss new procedures and interesting cases in the field of dentistry. Hi, Aniv, how are you?
Great, how are you?
Amazing. What have you brought for us today?
Yeah, well, today we brought old case that we restored about 20 years ago. The patient now is 8 years old. We want from the broken tooth he have to change his tooth to new ones, probably from zirconia, and to aesthetically enhance all the situation. Now, in this case, 20 years ago when it was made, he had one implant extremely buccally inclined in very aesthetic area. Mm-hmm. You can see right there when where we closed the screw channel with composite, and during those 20 years it absorbed some pigmentation, and this is how it looks now. Now, the patient was brought to us in a wheelchair. You can't add implants, you can't do anything because of his health issues. He just wanted to change the aesthetics of the bridge and make it look a little bit whiter and a little bit newer.
So aesthetics were not the first issue on your checklist?
No, aesthetics were the only issue in here. The function was not really an issue because it was going like this 2 years. It doesn't have any problems with food or anything else. Just want to replace the bridges to have better aesthetics, and he wants to eliminate the screw channel that goes to the buccal, both in upper and lower bridges. So in here you can see that we took off the bridges. The old ones were made from metal based, and probably with composite onto the metal and not porcelain. When we take off with metal, when you cast the metal, you can do any angles you want. You can make a screw channel that goes like 40 degrees into the buccal. You don't have any problems. Now we wanted to change it to zirconia. To change it to zirconia, it's a little bit of a problem. Not just that, we didn't want to have any screw channel that goes into the buccal at all. So you can see that on the one hand, we can add implants, we can do nothing. If it was different case, maybe we could consider adding an implant right next to the buccal one, and just don't use the buccal one. In this case, we can add implants. This implant we must use because you can't have this type of that many crowns without any implants. It would probably break. You have only 4 implants here. It's quite a problem because from on the one hand, you don't want to have a buccal screw channel. On the other hand, you don't have any options. You can't add implants, you can't do nothing.
What's the solution?
What we did here, first of all, we changed the multi-units. The multi-units we used a long time ago didn't suit it for CAD-CAM because it was a pre-CAD-CAM area, let's say. In here, we had used 1 millimeter multi-units, and for the problematic multi-unit, we used 0.5 millimeters multi-unit. On top of the 0.5 millimeter multi-units, we used very small sleeve. It won't screw to the multi-unit, but it just rests on the multi-unit. You have some resting, you have some forces the multi-unit takes, but it doesn't sit on the multi, you don't screw on top of the multi-unit. And because we did that, you can close the screw channel. You don't have a screw at all. For the lower bridge, we just took off the old bridge. We changed the multi-units, quite simple, and took impressions.
The buccal inclined multi-unit.
Yeah.
Why not to use an angulated one?
You can. You can use an angulated one. It would fix the screw channel inclination, but you'll have another problem. You'll have all the metal in the buccal area, because when you use angulated multi-unit, the buccal part is from metal, and you can see all that metal because of the inclination. Mm-hmm. So on the one hand, you can correct the inclination of the screw channel, but on the second hand, you have all of this metal. You can see it, you don't want it. It's very problematic when you don't have enough gingiva. When you have 2-3 millimeters gingiva, you can use angulate multi-unit. The gingiva will cover the buccal part of the multi-unit and you don't have aesthetic options. Mm-hmm. In here, you're using 0.5 millimeter multi-units. The smallest angulate multi-unit in the buccal area is around 1.5, maybe 2. You can't use, from aesthetic reasons, mm-hmm. an angulated type of multi-unit. Here we took the impressions on the multi-unit. You can see the buccally inclined multi-unit. You can see those three multi-units are straight ones without a problem at all. And this one is so inclined, it's a problem. In these cases, many times you need to check if you even can mill the bridge from zirconia. Because of these angles, there is a chance that you can't mill the bridge itself. The milling machine has some angles. You can't have more than 30 or 40 degrees between implants. So in this case, first of all, we checked if it isn't possible mm-hmm. to make. At the moment we knew it's possible to make, we could use straight multi-unit, and then we use special type of sleeve that is only 1.5 millimeters in height, and we just covered the sleeve and the multi-unit, and the multi-unit rested there. As you can see here, the sleeve is very, very small. The higher sleeve you have, mm-hmm. the more it would go to the buccal side. When you have a multi-unit like 45 degrees mm-hmm. inclination, if you use regular one, I don't know, like 4 millimeters. So you'll have 2-3 millimeters more in the buccal. You can't use that. You need to have the smallest possible sleeve. Yeah, possible. In this case, we used the smallest one, 1.5 millimeters in the height. And the other ones were 4 regular ones. The 1.5 goes without a screw. You just cement it to the bridge mm-hmm. and it rests on the multi-unit.
Oh, I see. So you don't screw it?
No, you don't screw it. You don't do anything. Mm-hmm. The only thing it does in functioning movements, in eating, speaking, the forces on the bridge goes onto the multi-unit because it rests on the multi-unit. It won't break that easily. Mm-hmm. In cases when, you know, you don't need to take extra precautions because of extreme forces, you can do it. And what other options do you have? You can't add implants, you can't use higher sleeves. These extreme cases when you don't have anything to do.
So the sleeve basically acts like a sort of suspension on the bridge.
Yeah, the multi-units that were used here are V-type multi-units. The V-type multi-unit has much smaller cone. It doesn't have like a regular multi-unit cone of about 2.5 millimeters. It's just 0.8. Because of the small cone, it has very large surface area for the sleeve to support on the multi-unit. When you cement the sleeve onto the bridge, you have a lot of surface. You have a great suspension between the bridge and the multi-unit itself. In these cases, you can't use it always. You can't cement all of the sleeves, use all of them 1.5 millimeters and use only 2-4 millimeters. But when you have a problem, you can use 1.5 and it holds great.
Mm-hmm. And it holds the pressure, everything.
Yeah, it holds the pressure. You have the suspension you need. You have the forces goes onto the multi-unit and it works great. In here you can see, because we used a small type of sleeve, mm-hmm. the result we have. You don't have buccal bulge, you don't have screw channel at all. You have pretty good aesthetics. We changed the lower bridge also. You have 3 regular sleeves of 4 millimeters and 1 0.5. In horizontal and vertical movements or forces that applied, you'll have some suspension. It will help to hold this bridge. In this case, when there is very large span between two implants, you can use it to compensate on some of the forces.
It looks great comparing to the what he came with.
Yeah, you know? If you compare it with what he came with, it probably looks great.
Both
yeah.
of them look great.
It's a great solution in cases when you have large span and you need to compensate and you have problematic angulated implants, and you can add implants. It's a very problematic case. Mm-hmm. It's not a regular case when you can use all of the parts and you can do crazy aesthetics and you can do everything, but sometimes this is what you need to work with. We're not trying to show here great cases with great aesthetics and very simple solutions. I'm trying to bring the problematic cases when you don't know what to do and you need to find a way to go around and use it and make prosthetics anyway. So in this case, using 1.5 millimeter is a great solution. It probably would hold till the end of this life.
Thank you for being here and for the case.
You're welcome.
See you next time. Thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow in order to stay tuned.